Tornadoes can happen at any time and can turn your life upside down, quite literally. It doesn't matter if you're in your car, home, or even an airplane, tornadoes don't care. They have one thing on their mind, destruction. Today we'll look at some of the worst case tornado scenarios and give you tips on how to survive them and stay on the ground. To do this, I threw myself in the path of a tornado in 6 different locations. But for legal purposes, and my will to live, we simulated it all with the help of Tuxedo Labs' game, Teardown. Let's just say, it didn't go so well.
Oh no.
I felt the trailer twisting, tumbling.
The lights kicked out.
Every year in the United States, tornadoes cause about $400 million in damage and kill about 70 people. How did this man survive being thrown 400 meters by a tornado? What tornado caused $450 million in damage and nearly crippled a skyscraper? And how did a flight in the 80s get caught up in a deadly twister? We'll get to all these questions in a breeze, but first, be sure to like and subscribe for more incredible action-packed survival videos. Before getting swept up, let's take a look at the different types of tornadoes. This is where the Fujita scale comes into play. The scale, named after Dr. T. Theodore Fujita, a meteorologist and professor at the University of Chicago, was created in 1971 to determine the strength and potential danger of different tornadoes. For nearly 40 years, tornadoes were ranked by wind speed from F0 to F5. The F stands for Fujita. After years of research, the scale was updated in 2007. The new official name for tornado potency is the Enhanced Fujita Scale, with tornadoes ranked EF0 to EF5. With the most severe wind speeds surpassing 320 kilometers an hour, you can only imagine how much damage an EF5 tornado is capable of. And although they're rare, there have been 67 of them reported worldwide, 59 in the United States alone. Now, before we explore the damages in our simulation, let's talk about the warning signs of a tornado. Dark or green-colored skies, low-lying clouds, large hailstones, and loud roaring that sounds like a freight train are all reasons to immediately take cover. You should also listen to your local news stations, an NOAA weather radio station, or even the internet to see if any information is available. Tornadoes are common in the United States because of the mix of terrain and environments across the country. Specifically, warm, dry air from the southwest, when mixed with warm, moist air from the Gulf of Mexico and cold air from the northern Rockies, is a recipe for disaster. The states in the middle of these conditions are the perfect breeding grounds for tornadoes. The area has been named Tornado Alley because it's the most common spot for severe storms. Over a dozen states, from Texas to South Dakota and Ohio to Montana, are categorized as tornado-prone states. Most of the activity happens between April and June, so plan your vacation wisely. They could also occur in winter months, although rare and can be deadly. In 2022 alone, tornadoes took the lives of 25 people, injured hundreds, and caused billions of dollars in damages. But that's not to say tornadoes only occur in the United States. Canada ranks second in the world in terms of tornadoes, with most of them happening in the provinces of Alberta, Saskatchewan, Manitoba, and Ontario. Now, I managed to score a beautiful home in Tornado Alley for a killer discount. And in all honesty, it seems pretty sturdy to me. Hey, survivors, welcome to my beautiful casa. There's my baby, my brand new red pickup truck. Ain't she a beaut? That's Betsy. And over here we have my media room, kitchen, and yep, my bedroom, where all the magic happens. Just put on fresh new Oh no, that doesn't sound good. Ah man, I just put new shingles on. Clearly there's gotta be a better way to do this. If you're in a house and see a tornado approaching, you'll want to get to the basement immediately. They're often the strongest part of a home, and you're less likely to be hit by flying debris. If that's not an option, seek shelter in a small room on the home's lowest level, ideally in the middle of the home, where there's more structural support from surrounding walls. This could be a bathroom, closet, or hallway. Stay away from windows, doors, and heavy objects. Doors specifically can easily be ripped off and are often a weaker part of a home's foundation. Heavy objects can also be lifted by strong winds, or at the very least fall over, potentially injuring or trapping you. And of course, windows, strong winds, glass flying everywhere, not ideal. You'll also want to protect your head, ideally staying under a sturdy table. Use blankets, a mattress, or a sleeping bag to protect your body.
The windows just go boom, they all exploded, and under our feet, the floor went kind of, it jolted a couple times, and then we just took off.
Roger and Roy Slatton were sucked out of their house when a tornado with winds exceeding 265 kilometers an hour ripped through. While searching for their dogs before heading to the basement, the two locked eyes before being separated by an EF3 tornado. Thankfully, they both survived. Roger was left with multiple cuts and bone bruises. Royce got it worse, 22 stitches when all was said and done. Luckily, their dog survived despite some minor injuries. But sometimes, no matter what kind of shelter you might have in your home, if a tornado is strong enough, you might just want to get out of there and go somewhere safe. Better get out of here.
No!
And I also forgot to get my home insurance set up. Well, I better get to work before I lose my house and my job. Contrary to popular belief, tornadoes can and will hit skyscrapers. Luckily, there aren't many major cities with tall buildings in Tornado Alley. But never say never. In 1999, an EF5 tornado ran through Oklahoma City, killing 36 and causing over $1 billion in damages. Imagine you're about to kick off the morning team meeting and suddenly things start getting shaky. A tornado is approaching and you're on the 28th floor. What would you do? Let's find out. First things first, stay clear of the elevator. If you can't get to the lowest level of the building, then try to get into the stairwell. Alternatively, the safest option is any room or area entirely inside the building, away from the windows. The same goes for an apartment building or any high rise. In 2000, Fort Worth, Texas was struck by an F3 tornado, which resulted in two deaths and $450 million in damages. The 35-story Bank One Tower was significantly damaged. 80% of its windows were ripped out and scattered throughout the downtown core. The building's steel frame helped maintain its structure, but the destruction and potential dangers brought on by the F3 tornado were frightening. Wow, where is everybody? Peter? Taylor? Anybody? And here I am thinking I was gonna be late. Huh? Evacuation notice. Oh, the tornado is back? It followed me to work? I better get out of here. That was insane! Okay, thank goodness I sheltered in the underground parking lot and Betsy's okay. Now that I technically have the day off, I guess I'll go shopping. Ah, the smell of some fresh Dunkin'. Excited to get me some donuts and coffee. Could also get a new suit, maybe a new iPhone. Should probably pick up some survival supplies too. Where is everybody? The new malls could be so creepy. If you can, try to get to the lowest level of the mall during a tornado to avoid severe injury or death. I don't care if the new iPhone just came out. All right, I'm all stocked up on survival supplies, got a new suit and some donuts. But I guess I'll Venmo them later. Wait, what's that sound? Oh no, not again! What do you want from me? I gotta get out of here. Make sure Betsy's safe too. If you find yourself in a car while a tornado is approaching, find shelter immediately, and not under your car. That's the worst place to be. The risk is debris falling on the car and heavy winds blowing away your shelter, in this case, the car. The best thing you can do is pull over, get out, and run to the nearest sheltered area. If you're out in the middle of nowhere and that's not an option, you'll want to buckle up and get as low as possible. Although cars have airbags, which may help protect you during a storm, shattered windows will be your primary concern. Do what you can to cover yourself and avoid getting cut. Once a tornado passes, try to get to the nearest sheltered area and be on the lookout for other tornadoes that may be coming your way.
We are hearing from the 16-year-old driver who somehow survived this encounter with a tornado in Eglin, Texas, Monday.
As crazy as that video was, the teen got back home safe shortly after having his car spun around. He escaped with just a few minor scratches.
That's actually me.
No way. Is that? All right, Betsy, we were made for this. I didn't get the V12 for nothing. Come on, it's time to punch it. Hit it to the metal. All right, haha, you can't catch me now. No, not Betsy. Oh, my baby. Well, at least I made it out alive. I'll miss you, Betsy. You're my favorite car. But I gotta get on a plane and get the heck out of here. But that doesn't mean tornadoes can't run through airports. That's a different story. In April 2024, a tornado touched down in Omaha, Nebraska, destroying several hangars and aircraft. Thankfully, the airport employees were able to find shelter, but the same can't be said for the more than 30 destroyed planes. Of course, we're not talking about commercial planes that can seat hundreds. Instead, we're looking at propeller planes, which seat anywhere from one to maybe a dozen people. Either way, let's see what happens. What? No one's here either? Well, I guess my pilot license will come in handy now. Always wanted to fly private anyways. Let's take this baby for a swirl. There it is again? All right, my boy Tom Cruise prepared me for this moment.
Maverick, sit down.
And I'm in a rush, so I could fly right past it. I'm not worried. Well, thank God I took that skydiving class, because that was close. And if you're watching this on a plane right now, I'm sorry, man. Although you'll likely never fly through a tornado, at least I hope not, there are some safety tips if you run into turbulence, a common occurrence on most flights. First things first, fasten your seatbelt. If anything happened, you wouldn't want to be lifted out of your seat. Listen to the crew and cabin members on board and try to limit your movement around the aircraft. Stay calm. You're flying with professionals, and freaking out may only make things worse. In most cases, the turbulence will pass after a few moments, and you'll arrive at your destination safe and sound. Sadly, this wasn't the case in the 80s for NLM City Hopper Flight 431 and the 17 lost souls on board. Aware of the thunderstorms, the two pilots didn't plan to delay their flight. As far as everyone was concerned, they would fly around it. Unfortunately, as they attempted to fly between two clouds, they got caught in what was considered an F1 tornado at the time. Although it was the second lowest ranking, it was still capable of winds up to 177 kilometers an hour. The strong winds tore off the right wing and ignited the plane's ruptured fuel tanks. The airliner plunged out of the sky and slammed into the ground, killing everyone on board. So flying into a tornado is possible, but it's extremely unlikely. Thankfully, we have far better systems now to detect these terrible twisters.
Baby, come on. Come.
They decide it's too dangerous inside their vehicle. The woman takes their two dogs and runs right into the tornado, ending up in a watery ditch.
Now there's one last scenario we find ourselves in. Walking through a tornado. Let me start by saying, I do not recommend it. Most people are well aware that a tornado is approaching, so they plan accordingly. They make sure they have flashlights and emergency kits and find shelter. But tornadoes can look like they're further away than they actually are and change direction quickly. I gotta be getting close by now. Oh no, are you kidding me again? Is this thing following me? Not happening again. I'm not dealing with this. I'm gonna get under that bridge over there. Whew! That was a close one. No! The last thing you want to do is take shelter under a bridge. It gives you very little protection against fly-in debris and could even kill you if the bridge were to collapse. Find a sturdy building to take shelter in. If that's not an option, lie flat on the ground, protecting your head with your hands. Avoid trees and cars, as the tornado may send those your way. Although being outside as a tornado passes isn't ideal, you can only hope for the best without options. Any nearby ditch would be good to dive into. Again, cover your head with your hands. Even if the tornado appears to be staying in one spot, it could still be making its way toward you. Imagine being thrown thousands of feet by ferocious winds hurling debris. How would you survive? Well, 19-year-old Matt Suter couldn't tell you how, but by a sheer miracle, he managed to stay alive after being thrown over 400 meters in the air.
I wake up 1,307 feet way down there by that red barn.
In 2006, 19-year-old Suter was swept up in an EF2 category tornado in Missouri. It not only took his grandmother's mobile home, but him as well. During the chaotic storm, Suter was hit in the head by a lamp and fell unconscious. When he woke up, he was in a field nearly a quarter mile away from where his grandmother's home originally was. The unlikely survival story led to Suter being awarded a world record for the furthest distance survived in a tornado. I'm sure that's one most people are happy to let him have. All in all, surviving a tornado is not only possible, but very likely, so long as you're prepared. Have an emergency kit, a battery-powered radio, a flashlight, and a plan in case you ever need to get through one. Get into a safe space to shelter yourself until the tornado passes, and don't come out until it's safe. Lastly, if it isn't apparent enough after watching my simulations, don't go anywhere near it. Don't try to chase it with your car or get too close. The further you are, the more likely you'll survive and walk away uninjured. Tornadoes can be devastating, but it's nowhere near the level of damage a hurricane can do. Put on your windbreakers, and we'll see how you fare in some of the deadliest storms on another episode of How to Survive.